And now for your weekly dose of metal. Here are your hosts, Morgan Danielle and Luco Blaze, on The Metal Experience.
Woo! Woo!
Yeah.
It's been a couple of weeks, but we just heard some motherfucking Iron Maiden, Remember Tomorrow, motherfucking Misfits, Astro fucking Zombies, and motherfucking Mega fucking Death in my darkest motherfucking hour. I am Luco Blaze with Morgan Danielle. We're here with Rabbi Dave and that guy Bill and the Darksiders.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Yay!
Whoa. My headphones blew up.
Yeah, mine did too.
Dave just blew... Oh, there we go.
That was weird.
Dave's blowing everything up! So why don't you guys go ahead and... This is your second time on. Why don't you guys go ahead and reintroduce yourselves to the world?
Yeah, well, I'm Eric Olson, and sitting to my left is Eric Olson.
Hello.
And to my right, the illustrious Paul Brass.
Elegant and alike.
We've got some technical difficulties. This would happen to us right now.
And we're missing... You shot it?
We're
missing Charlie, the the guitar man.
Charlie even coming tonight? What's
no,
up?
No, he's listening via satellite.
Yeah.
Hi, Charlie. Is it because you didn't want to talk to us last time? He was so silent.
Yeah, that's his deal.
It's okay. It's good to have the silent type, the mysterious type in the band.
We
it's
wanted to get him via satellite, but he
declined. If he wants to call in, he can call in.
Via the satellite.
We can talk to him. It's okay.
He just texted. He's on with us texting. He said, fuck, I wish I was there.
All right. Yeah. As long as you wish you were here.
He also texted a couple times. Anyway.
I'll try and say
What did you say, Dave?
Try the mic again. I think I fixed it.
Okay.
All right.
Woo!
Yeah.
He's
right,
back!
Cool. Yeah. I'm on.
I'll try and talk for him in his voice next time it's a comment.
It's nonsense.
Sweet.
Is this one on now, Dave? Speak into there.
So, the other day I was at the store.
Nope.
Is the switch on?
I don't know. This is on as much. It's on as much as we're gonna get it on.
Yeah.
Well, while we're doing that,
so you just fix one mic to break another one.
Maybe that's just the way it is.
A lot's happened since the last time the Darksiders were on with us. You guys have released an album.
Yeah.
Holy crap! There's an album now.
Yeah, it's a new self-titled album that's called.
But
it's called the Darksiders.
We changed our name.
Yeah,
it's called Shatter the System. How is it self-titled?
I will leave that to your imagination. No, just kidding. It's pretty killer. It's got the Darksiders logo on it and some original artwork.
Eric
on
over
front.
Here, the furthest. Yeah. Eric Olson did that on
the red.
Original, yes, Eric the Red.
The Red.
Eric the Red. There we go.
Yeah, I think there's some cool tunes on there. It's pretty much everything we've been playing for the last couple years at least. And,
nice.
Yeah, and now it's out in hard form.
How's that feel?
It's awesome. Yeah, and we're working on number two now, so...
Halfway done.
Yeah.
Nice!
Yeah, so we give you guys a couple CDs here.
I'm
some
super excited.
And stuff.
Yes.
Yeah,
because awesome.
I felt kind of unfortunate that we didn't have anything at the time last time we were here, so...
Still had fun.
Still had fun, exactly. That's what counts.
Who's Jailer Sari?
Oh, that's...
An old friend.
That's our friend. the Jailer.
The Jailer. No, that's Sailor Jerry's. That's
Maker
our,
of Fine
Rum. Old drink, yeah.
Fine Rum. You know, funny story is I used to buy booze for underage kids.
That's not a funny story. That's
it's hilarious.
How old were they?
You're helping
they
the
were
needy.
Like 19.
That's
but
right.
I was like,
awesome.
You know, I needed that for when I was 19, so I was just doing my part in the world.
I thought they were just trying to get laid.
Like,
paying it forward.
No, they were, I mean, they were all guys. I knew them.
Oh, never mind.
Like my buddy's little brother.
He liked it in the butt.
So anyway, whenever they'd ask you, like, hey, can you give us a bottle of Captain Morgan's? I'd always walk out with, like, Sailor Jerry or some off-brand rum.
Nice.
Like, you fucking idiots.
No, nice. Sailor Jerry's is
the on-brand.
And if you see a TV commercial, they have a Misfits song in it.
Nice.
I have seen that one.
Yeah. I have.
Dave, pull it up.
Yeah, that's cool.
Who did the album artwork for this?
This guy down here.
Yeah, I drew the artwork.
Really?
Everything was drawn by him.
Yeah.
What was the inspiration?
Freehand.
That was actually an old piece, but it still kind of rang true with how
it's kind of an old piece.
Actually,
Are you making fun of me?
His bucket list, something he hopes to do in the future.
Hey, man.
I found the commercial.
So, well, really quick, what is What is the cover? It's this guy on a sweet horse, and what is he carrying? He's dropping a bag full of skulls?
Yeah, yeah. And you know what? I'm thinking that all four of those skulls came from that bag, and I'm pretty sure that...
I count
that's
five.
Kind of the... Five skulls?
Yeah. No, the Darksiders skulls.
No, the Darksiders skulls. See, you okay. gotta look at the pink logo.
Yeah, okay.
yeah. It was supposed to be white, came out pink.
Yeah, that's what we were going for that. Yeah, like originally.
Thank you, said, CD Baby.
I told them I was like, more pink. That's what we need.
Because, you know what? Is slamming.
Nothing says metal like pink.
Oh, that's funny. That.
Yeah, but each one of those pictures is supposed to be for a song.
Nice.
So
yes, exactly.
I don't remember which one the cover is, but the back cover is for Zero Hour, and the actual cover, the CD picture, is for Shatter the System, the titular song.
Titular.
Now, what about the inside?
Yeah,
on the CD.
Yeah,
that's the same thing as what
the CD matches up with the picture.
Yeah. No.
Shatter
what song is? Oh, that one's also for Shatter the System.
Shatter is this picture.
Yeah.
The back is Zero Hour, and the front is what?
The front is to be
TBD.
Disclosed soon. Yeah.
To be decided.
Use your hands. Honestly,
you choose.
Honestly, nothing really, but yeah, that's fine. You know, it's nice to just have something that you can actually hold on to. I know there's a lot of people in music now and everything that's been going on with iTunes and all that for the years and years now.
I still don't like that.
People don't have like a hard, you know,
and that's what I want.
Case.
Hard copies are what you
exactly.
need.
And you hear that all the
be
time.
On vinyl.
Right, yeah,
yes!
yeah, that'd be
released
sweet.
On vinyl, yeah.
The hardest
and I'm
copies.
Pissed that we don't have like a vinyl like album to give you guys.
I'm pissed I don't have a record player to play.
We've got
the
a record
on.
Player.
You should get a record player.
Record
dude.
Player,
yeah.
sweet.
That's the thing, you know. Everybody likes the CD case, you know. Mm-hmm. There's a lot of people that still have that.
There's
stuff.
Already a phone call.
You
guys
drew
have the peaked interest.
The guy that's hanging.
It's probably Charlie
from the tree.
Charlie, go home. Okay. Oh wait, hold on. You're right. That's good.
You. Oh, I'm sorry. You're well, woo caller. You're on with the Metal Experience. Who the fuck is this?
Who is this?
I know.
Hi.
That's not Charlie.
Hello. Hi, girl.
Who's this?
How are you guys doing?
Mom,
good.
Is this you?
How is this?
That's
who's
Katie.
This is Katie. Katie from Genotype.
Oh, yeah. What's up, Katie?
Hey, girl.
Hey.
What's going on? You sound super tired. What are you doing?
Was this your alarm from the show, and then you just kind of like woke up to it?
Hey, I got your shirt on. Can you see it through the interwebs?
The interwebs.
He's wearing your shirt.
He's wearing a Genotype shirt.
Yeah.
Damn right.
No, he's wearing your sports bra. He found it.
Yeah. Eric looks best Genotype. With a sports bra.
Yeah, I need it. I need the support while I'm
running. He's the bro. Well, yeah, hey, Katie, how you doing?
Fine. What's up, guys?
Not much. Yeah. Not much. It sounds like you just woke up.
Ride.
You just wake.
I always sound like this.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah.
I always.
No, I really thought this was your alarm clock, and you just woke up to us. That'd be cool.
Oh no, you guys are in trouble. Strong
oh no, no, that's
no.
okay.
No, hey.
No.
I gotta break the romance.
Oh,
is that fucking Sean right there?
There you go.
I was in the fridge and she was turning me on. I was like, okay.
You were in the fridge. How did two people fit in the fridge?
I was in the fridge getting a Bush Light for her because I'm a bitch.
Oh,
and I'm eating a dirty brat right now.
Oh, very fun.
I'm eating a dirty brat and listening to the Darksiders.
Yeah, hey, I just want to let you guys know that we're playing a show with Genotype on September 20th.
Woo!
It's going to be at the Old Town Inn.
Yeah.
No way.
Mount a Prospect.
Yes.
Very cool.
Ye old
Did
town
you guys
inn.
Even know that?
No, hey, Sean, tell
what?
Me. You, yeah, Sean, you knew that we were playing.
No, they focused on their show this Saturday.
Yeah, that's true. They got another show playing this Saturday.
They're playing at Cairo.
I'm so stupid during the week. I don't know my ass from my hand.
Hey, no, Sean,
shows.
I saw you restringing your guitar.
I was like, yeah.
Nice.
So you have a show going on this weekend, too? Sean?
What are you talking to?
Katie?
Oh.
Yes?
What?
You have a show this weekend?
Who are you playing with?
Well, this weekend we're playing at the Cairo Lounge. Why are you playing?
Yeah, Cairo. Yeah.
Atlanta is burning, and so-called
burning
Saints.
Me burn my ass.
Yeah, Cairo's a good place, too.
We're going to be there, but not playing. Just watching.
Yeah.
You guys watch out for butter rolls, okay?
Oh, yeah. Love the butter rolls. Keep them coming.
Woo!
Looking forward to it.
Atlanta is burning. I'm going to start doing more butter rolls.
No. Yeah, Cairo, West Chicago, too.
Extra butter, please.
No.
Katie,
what the, sorry,
no.
excuse my ignorance. What
is
hell is
Katie
a butter
saying?
Roll?
Oh, you haven't seen his butter roll?
You can't do butter roll.
Oh, yes.
Sean, what's a butter roll?
What is a butter roll?
It's when he's doing awesome dance moves on the dance floor, thrashing out, and he does like a front somersault and gets up and does like a roundhouse kick and butters that roll.
You can do that?
Oh, yeah.
I want to see that.
Yeah, me too.
That sounds epic.
Explain that, because that was perfect.
Well, we had the perfect description of a butter roll. Those that can do it, post
your
videos now.
Thank you. I feel educated.
How's that new album out now?
No. Hey, are you guys playing new Darksiders tonight? I didn't hear you earlier.
No, we don't got it recorded yet. No, we're still rolling.
Yeah. Just our CD that we have
rolling
now.
Off the
same old stuff. But hey, you know what? The stuff's old. Stuff's good.
Old to us. It's been out for a year now.
Old and good.
We're working on new stuff.
No, we like that stuff. I was just wondering if you guys were doing your new stuff.
Oh, yeah.
We can thank Charlie for that.
No, we just have some.
Thanks,
he's not here, so we're going to throw the blame onto him.
Yeah. No. Yeah, that's the thing. Yeah.
Okay. All right, cool. Well, have a good show, you guys.
Awesome.
Thanks for calling.
Thanks for calling.
Thank you.
We'll see you Saturday.
Butter rolls. All
right.
Good show.
Bye, guys. Yeah.
Thanks, Katie. Thanks, Sean.
Well, let's do a track. What would the first track you like to hear off the... of the self-titled Shatter the System album.
Yeah, let's do the titular track. Let's do Shatter.
Shatter the System. That's track number Oon. Let's fucking
first
do
one.
It.
Actually spinning a disc right here.
Darksiders.
Hit it.
Ricky. We'll be right back.
Well, I expect that type of language at Denny's, but not here. Well, that's too freaking bad. You hear me?
Because we're throwing it back to Morgan and Luco on the Metal Experience.
That was good.
I love surprises.
I was like, what's going on?
That was awesome.
Woo! And we are back with the Darksiders. We just heard Shatter the System off the self-titled Shatter the System.
Yeah, titular track. Yeah.
Love it.
Titular track.
Well, you know, yeah. It's
Did you
it's
know it had the titular role in Star Trek or whatever?
The titular.
What does that word mean? Titular.
Like, title. It's based off the title.
I don't know. That album's
the lead
been...
role.
I was just thinking that sounded like testicular, but whatever. That's just me.
No, titular.
Well, no, that's
tits
the thing.
Too. Tits and testicles.
Yeah. What's wrong with you?
Man, this show has gone in the gutter real fast. No.
That's okay.
It often does. Yeah. It often does.
Your mind tends to wander to those dark places. But anyways.
No, that's the thing about that album, too. That all the songs that are on there is we've been playing them for now, like for a couple years at least. And, you know, recording them and everything has been really cool. And they just keep going and going and going. And, you
getting
know, we're
better,
on like... Exactly. Yeah, you know what?
Yeah, we're better at playing them now than we recorded them. So
well, that's
you should
thing.
Come out to a show and see it live because that's where it sounds like fucking awesome.
Well, that's the thing. You know, that's a lot of staying power that goes on. It's like I've noticed with a lot of bands and stuff, they could, you know, longevity is like 3 years or so. You know, you got something that's going on and you got a project that's going on.
Yeah, we're like totally not sick of playing these songs.
Yeah, it's like,
that's
you know,
a good thing.
Yeah, right.
Right.
You didn't write something that
you
hate.
Are you being sarcastic?
Right, exactly. No, that's the thing. Oh. You know, you got cover bands. They play the same stuff all the time, every night. You got stuff that you play that you write your own and you actually enjoy playing and everything and you enjoy it. And I mean, we get together every week and we play the same shit every week. And the thing is, we write new stuff too. But
yeah,
I mean, at the same time, it's like, you know, you do the same thing every week and stuff and you keep playing it and you don't think it's old. There's something to that. You know, there's something that, oh, shit. Okay. Wow. This is.
I'll toast to that.
You know? Here's a toast.
Hey.
Bush Signature.
25 ounces.
Yep.
For those that want to call in, it is 773-657-3341. Give us a call. We want to hear from you. If you want to toast,
Charlie, did you get that mic toast?
Yeah, 773-657-3341. Where did you guys record this album at?
Charlie's basement.
Northwest Audio.
Yeah, Northwest Audio. Yeah, no, Charlie's the fucking man with this shit, man. He records all the Geno stuff. He records our stuff. He's recording so-called Saints.
And the
production quality on it is just.
Were you guys
unreal.
Be recording the new album also?
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely.
Now, is it a legit studio that he's working in
his
basement or just
computers?
It's
you
where
know,
we jam in his basement, but he's got everything. You know,
it's his brain too. It's huge. He's got a huge brain. It's like his head's bigger than all of ours.
He's just got such a giant brain.
Oh, jeez.
And he's totally.
That's amazing too.
Humble, nice guy. So. Yeah. That's a good thing about this band.
Yeah, not at all critical ever.
We
you
all
know?
Like to hang out.
No, never. Yeah, he never looks at you.
Yeah. Well, maybe him.
Oh, he appreciates my improvisation, you know? He just does.
Well, that's the main idea here with the whole project that we got going on right now for years. It's been fun. I mean, like when you get into like a band, you're supposed to have fun. When it starts to become a business... or whatever, you're worried about making money off of whatever the fuck it is, then that's when you got problems. So, like, this whole time, we've not worried about any of that shit. We've just been worried about
having
fun.
Yeah, we have not made any money.
No, exactly. But, yeah. If
no
you
worries
at,
there.
Our band equity is through the roof, but that don't mean shit.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean? It's like...
That was a Reverb Nation.
Yeah.
Well, we're
band. They tell you your band equity, whatever the fuck that means.
Band equity.
Yeah, Reverb Nations are big. I don't know. We're trying to figure out so we can cash in.
Yeah, we'd like to cash in.
What's your band equity at then on Reverb Nation?
It's in the 3,000 range. Like, you know,
what does that mean?
Is that
yeah, we'd like to cash in.
I thought it was like 3 million.
It's like credit card airline points. I think once you get to 3 million, you get a dollar.
So like 3,000 is like $3.
No,
like
it's
Kmart.
It's more like yen. I think we're 0.03 cents with that. So we're working.
So
our
it's
way
like 3 cents.
Like
3 cents.
Yeah.
To like a dime, right? A dime?
Yeah, so we got like $3 in like actual money, you know.
Well,
fuck it. You know, we're having fun with it. That's the main thing.
Yeah, I don't get it.
Writing
but,
some
you know,
killer songs and having a great time, you know.
Exactly. Yeah, that's the whole point of the whole project anyways, is just to have fun and, you know, do what we've been doing. And finally we got something.
What do you mean, man? We're here to take over the world.
Someone's drunk. He's already trying to conquer the world over here.
I'll put that in my planner.
Join the dark side. Where do you see the Darksiders going? Like, where would you guys like to see yourselves?
Vietnam!
Hill 364!
We're going to Nam. We're actually touring over there next week. Yeah.
Wow. It's a little man to go to Nam.
No, I'm sorry. You just said it. No, actually, to logically answer that question, I don't know, to keep having fun and keep playing what we're doing.
Yeah, we don't...
One day make it to Vietnam.
We've been fortunate enough to play with some really awesome bands. Yeah. Sparkplug Assassins, who we're playing with coming up. We've become friends with them, and they're really cool guys, great music, and we've been lucky enough to play with them. Some other bands, you know, Genotype, we like playing with them. So just we kind of pay attention to what other bands are out there that we like that seem like cool people.
Yeah, that's the main thing. When you play shows... Like,
play good shows with cool bands.
Yeah.
You know, obviously, everybody wants, it'd be cool as hell to make a bunch of money and do all this and all that, but honestly, none of us are really in that spot in our life to be able to do, you know, just drop everything
Go touring.
So,
right.
Might as well just have fun making music.
Yeah, so we want to do as much as we can in the local area, you know. I mean, we want to be a band that's...
Yeah, just keep writing and recording,
respectable,
making
albums.
That,
you know, we get to play cool shows, but nothing too crazy, I guess.
Well, that's the thing with staying power, too, is I've noticed that a lot. It's like if you have staying power and you don't give a shit, like, what people think about what your stuff is, really, it's like, you know, we just do it for... I mean, I hate to say that, but I mean, it's like we're doing it just for the fun of it. You don't really constantly think, oh, God, what does he think of it? What does they think? What do they think about it or anything like that?
Well, we do
it
for us. We like it.
Yeah, exactly. So you're not thinking about that 24/7. So that's staying power, you know, and you keep doing that. You keep doing that. You got years under your belt. You keep doing it. And then suddenly... You know, hey, yeah, okay, you got 200 likes, you got 300 likes. So, you know, on Facebook, whatever.
But you also have albums out there that people have physical copies of that can remember you guys by. You have been a memory to somebody, too.
Sure, exactly.
Hallelujah.
Do you guys have kids at all? What do they think of?
I have a robot.
My son's our biggest fan.
Yeah?
He's 8.
Does he know all the Darksider
lyrics? Yeah, he knows all of it. Yeah.
Eric's forced him to be in a closet like with the dark side.
The next song we're going to play is called Dead and Gone, and the chorus goes, "Dead, gone, in the fucking ground." And so I'm teaching my kids to swear, basically. Teaching them all the good swear words.
Is that what they listen to on the way to school?
Yeah. We got it playing on the bus, you know.
Oh, jeez.
It's hilarious because...
They got a slamming system.
Charlie's wife got called in because their son had been singing our song.
He's 3, by the way.
And they're like, you got to come in here.
He was singing that song.
He was singing our song. So he was kind of like, sorry about that.
That's awesome.
But yeah, you know, it's good for the kids. You know, the kids love it.
Radio rock
Disney.
Star.
Radio Disney.
That doesn't cut it anymore. Come on. You're teaching them metal and punk and all that fun stuff that they deserve to know.
Yes. Well, let's play Dead and Gone. I want to... Dave, you on the phone there? Are you too busy? Or are you talking on the phone? What's going on?
He's got his cell phone on.
Hey, Mom, I'm sorry.
We're doing a radio show.
Let's do
pay attention, kids.
Some Darksiders, Dead and Gone, track number 7.
Yeah. Oh,
we got it.
The self-titled Shatter the System.
Yeah.
I'm
Listening to The Metal Experience.
We've assembled a collection of bands who have drummers.
I do magic.
Well, it's easy if you try, Dick.
Now sit back and listen.
Woo! And we're back. This is The Metal Experience. I'm Morgan Danielle with Luca Blaze. We're sitting here for the second time with the Darksiders. And we just heard, what was that called? Dead and Gone?
Yeah.
Very nice. What inspired that track? Anybody? Who wrote that?
Oh, I wrote that.
Are you going to cry? Are you going to cry? What's going on over here?
I wrote that, and I honestly, yeah, I did. I don't know. It goes back to the old days when I used to be at a cattle ranch. Dead and Gone used to, it came from an old cat. Hey, Paul, please.
Yeah, let him explain.
I'm opening up a part of my heart here, okay, that no one has heard. I used to be at a cattle ranch, probably in the 80s.
You should find real and, sad music.
This was what, like 89, right?
Well, yeah, it could have been the late 80s. I was on a cattle ranch.
It explains the N apostrophe, like guns and there used to in be this, roses, dead, gone.
Right. Well, there used to just be this young calf. His name was Meadow.
Oh, God.
And, you know, he got sick one year.
You birthed him.
He was at date birth, yeah. He actually was. And there was a couple seasons that went and came and gone. And at that point, I remember it was a cold
actually,
autumn.
Actually, the whole time, you weren't sure whether it was a male or female. So you tried to milk it?
We didn't know. Yeah, and the milking process took place. And at that point, we actually...
That's when we found out it was a male.
Yeah, and then Meadow actually got sick. And that really sucked. And, you know, I knew her for a long time. She had one glass eye. And it always was kind of pointed in the opposite way, and I didn't
prosthetic
know if she,
horns,
right? And I didn't know if she was looking at me or with. Either way, regardless, I'm going to wrap the story up. It's very. You can make fun of it all you want.
It was
want,
a
Eric,
long, cold winter.
Yeah, no, but either
it was
way,
autumn. Damn it,
Dead and Gone is all about basically Meadow, you know, and that's what kind of hair.
Now
her.
She's dead.
And now she's dead.
Yeah, gone in the fucking ground.
He's really crying, guys. Seriously.
Yeah. You know, where's the Kleenex?
This isn't funny anymore.
Where's the Kleenex?
I don't have any.
I thought she
was dead and made into hamburger, but
no. Oh my God, he's actually crying.
Veal.
You guys don't care.
It was a young cow.
Double burger.
You guys are all.
I can see the
savages
corner of his
you're
eye.
All savages.
Oh my God, I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to bring.
Step on your feet.
Do you not care about my lyrics? No, you know what? The only one who cares about my lyrics is Charlie.
Yeah.
And he's not here.
Charlie, I know you're out
well,
there.
We have a phone call. It could be Charlie.
Oh, God.
Cut this music. Let's go.
Oh, God.
So sorry about that. We had to put you on hold while Eric cried a little bit. I do apologize. Who is this?
Hello.
Caller. Dave. Didn't patch him through. Caller. Hello.
Hello.
Who is this?
Mystery caller.
Who is this? Mystery caller?
Comfort me.
This is Darth Sidious.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Dark Sidious. Yeah.
Dark Sidious.
Sounding good, Mr. Sidious.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And then what's your real name?
My real name shall not be known to you.
I think I know who this is just because of the dark, ominous, mysterious silence.
Sounds like a stalker to me. Yeah.
Do you have anything you can give to Eric? He just got over the death of his calf.
Yeah, he was crying here, and you weren't here to comfort him.
No. Please help me, Mr. Caller.
Did you make him cry when he recorded it for him to feel the emotion while he played?
The angst.
Yeah, there was a lot of heart there, a lot of pain. If you're the true identity caller, I think you are. You'll make me feel better. Open your heart.
and your wallet.
Open your heart and your wallet.
Thanks for calling to end that sad story.
Was that the Incredible Hulk theme song playing, Dave?
I believe the caller can verify the story.
No, hey, you know what? I was really just calling in to talk to the hardest motherfuckers in America.
Yes.
Are they on the line?
Oh yeah. Ready?
Yeah.
Those motherfuckers find value at Farm and Fleet.
Well, they do find value.
We bust into a jingle.
That's the new direction we're heading in, actually. We're doing punk covers of jingles.
There you go.
Yeah.
Have you recorded some of these jingles?
Not yet.
Okay. You should.
We could do an a cappella for you right now.
Okay.
I'd love to hear it.
Are you going
to
do this with them?
Yeah, let's
I'll phone
come
in
on,
my
dude.
Part.
Yes.
All right, let's
no,
hear,
I'm down.
Let's
I'm
hear
down.
Your jingle.
Here we go. We'll start off like this.
Hottest motherfuckers in America. Hottest motherfuckers in America.
Find value. Farm and Fleet.
Oh my god. How many times did we practice that? That was spot on.
All right. So we're writing the song. The last song we just finished.
Okay.
And he's supposed to be finishing his parts, coming up with stuff. And we're like, all right, we're at practice. We have our parts ready. You want to play the song? No, man. I was learning the Farm and Fleet theme song on bass.
Theme song.
See, you know, that's interesting because there's a lot of interesting jingles out there that actually have really good beats to it. You know?
Oh, yeah, like the Kit Kat theme song.
Do you have a Kit Kat jingle, too, that you created?
No, I don't remember that.
How's that one go?
Give me a break.
Give me a break. Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar.
Give me a break.
Give me a break.
Give me a break.
Give me a break.
Break me off a piece of that Kit Kat bar. Yeah, there you go. Charlie, you know that one, right?
That's his fave.
I think he hung up. Charlie, you there?
He left. I don't know those guys.
Charlie's like on the ground. Charlie.
Yeah. No, I'm still here. I'm still here, barely. Like, I'm hanging on by a thread right now. So close to hanging on.
Yeah, he loves us.
So, Charlie, what's the most frustrating part about recording your own band?
Ooh, Eric Olson.
Thank you.
Which
me,
one?
Right? I knew
it. Yeah, what letters, dude?
No, I'm going to leave it at that.
Wow.
Got off easy, Paul.
Yeah, I know. That's not a PB.
Yeah, Paul got
either.
His shit done in like a day.
Yeah. He did. Well, if I was any problem to you during any of this time, Charlie, I want to actually, like, you know, announce my sorrow.
No more sad
and my pain towards of anything that you've had to deal with.
Actually, it's too fucking funny. We can't get a serious track down.
Hey, you know what? Yeah, you know what? Hey, that sounds sarcastic. And just for that, that's three Amber Box.
Oh, there we go. Yeah.
Tomorrow, you ain't going to have many Amber Box left.
Yeah, I know, yeah.
And for that, you owe him 20 push-ups.
No
more demerits.
Yeah, he's a threatening fridge vacuum right now, actually. That, if you ever know that. The fridge that we have downstairs, fridge
shall
vacuum.
Be chained in
the yes, exactly. Well.
Yeah, we're going to be jamming tomorrow, and I told these guys that every time they fuck up and say something I don't like, I'm drinking one of the beers. So, at this point, their three beers are gone.
Woo!
And we'll see how well they do.
Glug, 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 glug.
Yeah, he's a taskmaster. I mean, really, when it comes down to it.
A mind bender.
A mind bender. No, we love you, dude. It's all good.
Hey, a toast?
A fucking toast?
Here we go with the bushes again.
The bushes.
I'm done.
The signature bushes.
Mike toast.
Well, Charlie, we miss you. We will see you soon.
I bet you should have been down here.
What track do you want?
Hey, you know what? I'm sorry to all of the masses of fans that I couldn't make it in tonight.
So they're lining up for a signing and they're disappointed.
Yeah, I know.
There's somebody right here staring at me right out through the window, and he's saying, "I love Charlie Esposito." Esposito.
He wants to
know. He's like, "Fuck yeah."
And I'm just like, I got to turn him away. I'm not Charlie Esposito, so I like, I can't really tell you. I mean, I can't sign your name. Can I sign your name? Can I make this fan happen?
Yeah. No, you can. You're authorized. Yeah, I didn't want to incite riot.
So all right, really okay. Because I got to feed my way through the seven people before that. But I mean, honestly, dude, I got to do that. I'll do that for you, okay?
Well, roll up in your limousine. No. Take off those shades. Come on. Roll up in that white suit and those cowboy boots.
There we go.
Exactly.
You have power. Hey, Eric, I grant you power of attorney.
Sweet. Okay. POA. POA.
That was a mistake.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Well,
worst thing you could ever do.
We're going to have Eric sign the CD for you.
Oh, yeah.
So
there
technically,
you go.
We'll have two signatures from Eric on the CD since you're not here tonight.
And your signature is like a smiley face, right?
Just a smiley face.
All of them. Yeah.
Is that
Don't
it?
Forget Under that important rainbow. Part.
No, I think Charlie's signature is like a Hello Kitty. Like, no, it's not. I'm kidding. I kid.
Well, Charlie, what track do you want to play for the world next?
The one that you're most proud of off the album.
Yeah.
Oh, well, that would have to be fucking Vagenda.
Yeah!
Whoa.
Easy.
Woo!
Sorry.
You're not the only one that's very stoked about that song.
No, everybody's... But then after that, can I get two requests?
Absolutely. What else do you want to hear?
Okay.
Great.
All right, my second request is going to be Kill a Guy. So let's play those.
Kill a Guy. That's one that
Pauly right here sings.
Woo!
Woo!
Paul.
You got those,
Paul
Dave?
Is we doing a twofer?
Yes, we are.
Well,
all
we'll
right,
play those
Charlie.
Two for you. Thank you, Charlie, for calling in. We'll see you very soon.
Right.
See you tomorrow, Charlie.
We'll talk to
Charlie.
You guys. Talk to you guys later. Cheers.
Take care. Cheers.
See you.
life is not rock and roll.
You're goddamn right.
This is the Metal Experience, and now back to Morgan and Luco.
Those songs were for you, Charlie.
I want to dip my balls in it. That's because of the whole
yeah.
Those were two other Dark Sider songs. What were those tracks called?
We had Vagenda followed by Kill a Guy.
Kill a Guy. And, what are those two songs about? Anybody?
Well, Vagenda is basically about somebody who poisons someone else.
Someone who poisons a vagina?
So that's not called
no,
Kill a Guy?
No, actually, yeah. No. It's actually
Kill a Guy was
down.
About killing a guy.
Yeah. Ah.
Vagenda.
Yeah, it's hard to understand.
Actually about
it's far-fetched.
A girl killing a guy. Mm. She had her vagenda.
With her vagina?
No, it was poison.
It was a poisonous vagenda?
Yeah.
We're thinking about doing a second part to that, but I'm not really sure.
What's
man,
it called?
Mangenda?
Boygenda?
Boygenda?
Magenda monologues.
Yeah, I don't know. It's who knows at this point. Yeah, and there's a lot of litigation. There's a
your
lot
songs.
Of,
your songs are very dark.
I know. You know, we want to really. Well, we have.
Yeah,
a
what's
secret.
Up with that?
We tried to be the Bright Siders, and it didn't come across too well. So
no,
you know.
No, it didn't. No, people hated that. So it's like, you know, if everyone hates your bright side, then you gotta go to the dark side.
There you go. There you go.
That's pretty much it.
You have cookies, glasses. Right? That's what they always tell
oh,
me.
Oh yes. Come to
no.
the dark side. We cookies. Have cookies.
Oh yeah.
Actually, we have cider.
Cider.
Yes, yeah, dark cider.
Dark,
poison
dark
cider.
Cider
right?
Like apple cider. Yeah.
Do you really have a beer?
Well, we made a
that'd
concoction
be awesome.
Once.
Yeah, no, but no.
Are you gonna
it
make?
We made a
make
concoction.
One.
It involved Sailor Jerry's. So
there
you go.
What else did it involve? Are you not allowed to give out the secrets?
No. It was a beer. A cider and Sailor Jerry's.
Don't
together.
Tell them how many ounces, though.
No. Yeah, that's a trade.
That's
secret.
The secret.
I thought
that's,
you just put it in a bucket and kind
of
three-fourths ounces.
Hey, hey, hey.
Three-fourths quarter ounce.
That's classic.
No. No, just kidding. It's not a big deal. It's only a half ounce. No, just kidding. No. Honestly, we.
No, it was like basically looking for something to drink at the end of the night and.
Well, we
that's
got one
we
of
had.
These and one of these and some of this. So,
yeah,
and
let's
it was
share
really
it.
Good.
Yeah, and
that's
it was bad.
Yeah, it actually worked out pretty good. Yeah.
There's a whole lot of bad going on there.
Well, with that, Dave, what do you have to say to that?
Could I speak to the drug dealer of the house, please?
Let's hear it from the soundboard.
Cookies?
Actually, that kind of reminds me of how a drink me and Bill somewhat created just out of randomness.
You created a drink, you straight edge son of a bitch?
It was, yeah, I thought of the name before I actually...
What was it?
Had
tell
the
me.
Drink. It's called Imagine Dragons.
Oh, nice.
And what's in it?
Absinthe, Jim Beam Fire, and Dragon Juice.
So are you talking about real absinthe?
Yes.
Yeah, I had a friend who brought some of that back from Spain, and I didn't believe in it, and I did a few shots, and then I believed in it.
It's 110 proof.
Yeah, supposedly, if you drink that, you'd start to trip.
I was hallucinating.
I thought you were supposed to do that.
Negative. When you pour it over sugar,
the sugar
has opium in it. That's what the tripping caused.
However he prepared it, he brought it back, smuggled it in a suitcase, and I didn't believe in it, and all of a sudden, it was
you're supposed
whole
to.
Other party.
Yeah, you're supposed to pour like an ounce in a glass and put a sugar cube over like a slotted spoon.
Yeah.
Pour some water over that and it will dissolve it.
Yeah.
That explains why I didn't trip on it.
Yeah, I just got really hot.
No. It was really good.
It's like, man, it's fucking hot in here.
Actually, it was,
that's funny.
Mark Rubano.
Anyways, how was
out there
that?
In Redondo Beach, California. Thanks, man.
Did you try it?
You tried it. You liked it.
It was delicious.
Okay. You're going to have to
video.
Make me some of that.
There's video footage of me trying it.
Where did you get this absinthe from?
Uh-oh,
my family had it.
I think it's legal now, ain't it?
What?
Well, but it's not the real stuff.
Yeah, you can get the stuff without the wormwood or whatever in it.
I'm waving. Yeah, we have fans out here. Hey! How's
Dark
it going?
Siders!
Wave to the friendly people.
Old Town Inn, September 20th.
Calm down, fans. We'll be out in a minute.
They're banging on the glass.
Yeah. September 20th. Yeah, Old Town Inn. We're going to be there.
Yeah, that's our
next show.
Woo-woo.
Sparkplug Assassins, debut of Surrender to Throne.
Lots of sparklers.
Awesomeness.
Yes, sparklers.
Genotype.
Motherfucking Genotype.
They promised me bubbles and sparklers.
Yeah, I know. I can't promise that. I mean,
we will be serving meat cake at the
meat
show.
Cake.
That's our new gimmick. We're going to serve meat cake.
So is it Darksiders. We have meat cake.
Is it
layered.
Cake made out of meat or is it just a meat?
No. It's meat and cake.
Okay. Here we go.
Ground beef covered in chocolate frosting.
Yeah.
That sounds delicious,
actually.
Actually,
I owe a meat cake to
Dave.
Remy.
You can get them at the dollar store.
Yeah, Eric knows how to frost those.
Oh, my gosh.
cake.
All right.
Anyway.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
What else you got for us, Dave?
So the bassist from Suicidal Tendencies died.
What?
Yeah. Oh,
you didn't hear about those?
It was recently, yeah.
Trujillo, but the original guy, I think it was. Yeah.
No, they're the guy that's on tour right now.
Oh. The original OG.
Oh, he's the one who died? All right.
Tim Roberts Williams.
Yeah, they've had several lineups, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they're still going to go on tour with Exodus and Slayer. So
Exodus. But they
haven't announced the replacement yet.
No, like, he's not related to, like, Robin Williams, right?
No, I doubt it.
It's just a coincidence.
Curious. Williams, I don't know. I
The Offspring are going to start work on new music after the Summer Nationals tour.
Good. All I was just listening to them in the shower.
Yeah. I was not.
Every Time I Die and Tucci Amore are announced on Australian tour.
Oh, that doesn't matter to me.
You can just go to Australia.
I want to go to Australia. Somebody won't take me to Australia.
The Melbourne stream a new song called Brass Cupcake.
Oh, anything with brass in it is good.
Yeah.
What else you got, Dave?
I mean, it sounded like we went to a commercial break.
No. It's just this is the Melvin song.
So, what else you got?
Code Orange streamed their full album, I Am King. And the Melvins announced a new album called Hold It In.
So, you went from a Melvins to Code Orange to another Melvins.
Yep.
So, speaking of the Melvins, I just bought a... Tomahawk 45 in Seattle. I was pretty stoked.
Nice.
I haven't listened to it yet. If anyone knows Tomahawk is, they're pretty cool.
They got Hold It In, that's like
from
about
the Melvins and
needing to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, the first track off the album is called Bride of Krankenstein, so this should be pretty interesting.
Whoa, that might say something.
Let's see. We also got Slipknot have finally announced the new details of their album.
Yep.
And a new song.
And what are the details?
It's track listing and stuff like that.
Who's the
and they'll
new
be playing
members?
With Korn I don't think they're Kings 810 or something.
Yeah, they still haven't announced a new drummer, but rumor has surfaced that it's the Rev from Avenged Sevenfold.
Nice. Wow.
They go from Chris Adler to the Rev.
Amazing.
It's rumored because he was hiding from creditors and he wanted to join a better band.
That's just like that headline the other day.
That was
Pop,
like
Coor comes
the
out
worst thing you
could have
said. That was great.
They didn't turn to shit until he died.
Oh,
so anyway.
Goodness.
Well, yeah, he wanted to join a better band. That's what the rumor says anyway.
He's still alive, apparently.
Yeah, he faked his death because for hiding from creditors. And no one will know it's him because he's always wearing a mask. So this works out.
Oh, my God.
What else you got for us, Dave? That was terrible.
Tour dates for Unearthed, Darkest Hour, Carnifex, Origin, Eye the Breather are posted up. They're going to be at Mojo's in Joliet October 16th.
Oh, yeah. I want to go to
that,
but
Tuesday?
That's a Thursday night, and unfortunately, I can't do it. Luca's got softball. But MC Chris playing Subterranean.
Master Batters, baby. Master Batters for life.
Wait, when's MC Chris playing?
Yeah.
October 17th at the Subterranean.
We need to go to that.
MC Chris.
What else
I'm
you got,
a ninja,
Dave?
I'm a ninja.
There's a trailer out there called Let There Be Guar, and it's a documentary about Guar.
Oh, nice. Yeah.
The trailer was posted, so it looks pretty cool.
That'll be worth catching.
Guar. Yeah, absolutely. They were the best band.
They were the best.
They're still together. they're playing shows.
Actually, they did a...
Who's singing?
Yeah, they did a
song. I don't know, but they're playing Riot
Beefcake,
Fest.
Beefcake the Mighty.
Nice. The bass player.
I am Beefcake.
They did an Unplugged one time on MTV. It was pretty good.
What?
Yeah.
Still in costume.
Still in costume playing acoustic guitars?
Tuxedos, too.
Really?
All the fluids were pumped out by hand at that show.
I was going to say, if you have a chance, check out this.
I never know if you guys
Scum
are
Dogs of the
Universe. Yeah. Scum Dogs of the Universe. Awesome album.
Yeah, that was a good album.
Best album.
What's a good thing to check out?
I would say the David Brocky Experience, if you can find any of that old stuff.
David Brocky Experience is the shit.
Yeah, no, I'm just saying.
I've only heard a couple of tracks,
that.
But they're it's very good.
And the guitarist leaves Chimera for some reason.
Which, like, the eighth guitarist?
Emil Wrestler. I'm not sure.
His last name is Wrestler?
I guess. I'm not pronouncing.
Is he a wrestler?
If I had that last name, I'd show people my wiener all the time.
Oh, boy.
Alrighty.
I don't know why, but that's just what I would do.
All right. Faith No More is making a new album.
Oh,
yes. Shut up. No.
Yeah, they are. They are.
No.
What?
I heard this.
Yep.
Yeah,
Mike Patton's in Faith No More, and he's also in Tomahawk.
Like Tomahawk.
Don't even.
He's
ever
the lead singer in Tomahawk.
Nickelback.
Yeah.
What about Mr. Bungle?
Never.
Mr. Bungle. Yeah. Mr. Yeah. Bungle's
on,
the
Charlie's
too.
Not here. We don't have to talk about Nickelback.
Do they have a name for the new album yet?
What's wrong with
Nickelback?
Do they have
an
ETA?
No, not yet. Again, they
talking
just
about Faith No More here. Don't
yeah,
even
Faith No More, awesome band.
Album of the Year is my favorite. I don't know. That's just my favorite Faith No More album.
Slayer's in the studio again.
Uh-oh.
Nice.
No, yeah, not cool.
Slayer without Lombardo.
Well, we got to do
or
something.
Or Jeff.
They just need to give
well,
up.
Well, yeah, but Lombardo.
It should be.
They got the Rev.
They got the Rev.
Rev's playing for
now
everyone.
Now he's joined for them, too.
They got the Rev. They got him out of the ground.
It's like
right?
weekend at Bernie's.
No, yeah, they got Andrew. No, listen, they got
strings in.
They got Andrew McCarthy playing drums.
Cricket, who?
Who's that?
Weekend at Bernie's. Weekend at Bernie's.
Oh, the guy from.
Okay, yeah, Andrew
way
McCarthy.
Way to go there with the vague reference.
Andrew McCarthy.
Who's the director?
It is Heartthrob.
Zemeckis. It was Zemeckis.
Andrew.
I love that idea, though. The Rev is a Weekend at Bernie's kind of thing.
Oh, my God.
This is getting pretty terrible. People are like, click, shut this off.
Wouldn't be the first time.
Yeah, right? What else you got, Dave?
Mushroomhead had decided to dress like Nazis for their new music video.
Oh,
That's nothing new. They've done that before.
Have
yeah.
They? Well, at least they're committed.
I've seen them dressed like
it's
Nazis.
It's a good thing
before.
They're named after dicks.
Yeah.
Oh.
Wieners.
And
I never made that connection.
And there is a new Baby Metal song out. Apparently it's about
Baby Metal rules.
Please pull this up, new Baby Metal song.
It's about bacon, lions, booty, donkeys, and old dead guys.
I like all those things.
That only makes sense.
Please play this track.
We like bacon, donkeys.
Give me chocolate.
Covered bacon.
Seriously, though.
Oh, yeah. Off the album that I have. This isn't new. This is just new video. But they're badass.
What song is this? It's all in Japanese.
Touching Hugo's. What?
Yeah, that's what they said.
Rich Jordan's in his undies.
I think some American dude's just like, this is what it sounds like they're saying.
Yeah, apparently it's like misheard lyrics and bad translation.
No, but seriously, Baby Metal rules.
That it does.
Yeah.
If no one out there has checked them out,
yeah, I was like, wait a second, is that what they're really? At first, I was like, is that what they're really saying?
No.
Doesn't make any sense. Who's Scott? Oh my goodness!
It's like anime metal.
Yeah,
but who cares? It's awesome.
I want to hear that. I want to hear that. I want to see that Sailor.
Sailor Jerry one.
You still have that up there?
Yeah, I still have it.
Let's play it real quick.
Sailor Jerry.
Yeah, we're trying to get sponsored by them.
That would be awesome.
It's not working.
This is where eagles dare.
That it is. That's pretty cool.
Nobody's touched the
Misfits. Yeah, this is a fucking commercial for rum. And they're playing Misfits.
We walk the streets at night. We go where eagles dare. They pick up every loser. They pick up every loser. With jaded eyes and features. You think they really care? I ain't no goddamn son of a bitch.
And they're like building a ship while they're like filming this.
Yeah, this is like dry dock.
Dry dock?
Space dock.
Yeah,
we're not, we agreed not to talk about that.
Dry dock.
How long is this commercial?
I think it's like 2 minutes. It's like,
this is the full
the
commercial.
Full version.
This is the full commercial.
7 minute long song.
Yeah, they don't air this on.
Is anybody else going to Doyle on the 12th?
Hey, Sailor Jerry's, we'll do it for free.
Anybody?
Just
anybody?
Give us some bottles of Sailor Jerry's and we'll play for you for free.
Dead Man's Hand is selling tickets for $12.
Doyle, that motherfucker is ripped.
Yeah.
He's like 50 years old and
I think Glenn Danzig's getting back together with them to do like a tour and shit.
There were some talks, but I don't know what's going on with it. That would be sweet, though.
Yeah, hell yeah.
But Glenn Danzig just keeps getting crazier and crazier.
He's doing an Elvis album now.
It's like he thinks
nice.
His shit doesn't stink type of guy. It's like, dude.
Well, that's how he's always been.
That's true.
You're actually
hey,
close.
Since we're talking about Glenn Danzig.
Yes.
That's one of the new songs on our album.
You're
we're
doing
writing
Danzig
a song
cover?
About Glenn
oh,
Danzig.
Oh, no. We're writing a song about Glenn Danzig.
Ooh.
It's called Dagger.
Yeah.
Nice.
And here's the thing. Yeah, Dagger is one of the...
It's a true story.
The new songs about Glenn Danzig.
It's how I could have killed that motherfucker.
You had a run-in with Glenn Danzig?
Well, I met him in 93 on the Danzig 3 tour. They were doing a signing at Rolling Stone Records.
I met him in 98.
during the Satan's Child 666 album.
Was he a jag-off?
He was doing a signing. No, I didn't really talk to him. I'm just he overpriced, man, you're awesome, and he signed my poster and my CD, and that was it. I was like, thanks.
He overcharges for merch.
Does he?
Yeah. He does. Riot Fest, like, 2 or 3 years ago, I was looking at the stuff, and he wanted, like, 25, almost 30 for a shirt.
That's average.
Well, I mean, that's kind of average.
20 to 30 for a shirt, though?
30 sometimes. Yeah, it's average. But I've seen that before.
I've paid 45 before.
What?
He also wanted 20 for a
t-shirt?
Yeah.
He also wanted 40 for a bandana.
40 for a bandana? That's crazy.
$40 for a bandana?
Yeah.
Well, can I tell you the...
yes, please.
Not to be off the record here, or off...
not to get off the record here, but on the record, off the record.
The new album we're going to be releasing is going to be called Mothership.
Ooh.
So we want to establish that name. I want to have that song right now, but we haven't recorded
anything.
Do you have an intro?
We're going to write the whole thing and then...
Yeah,
it sounds like you guys are coming off of a spaceship.
Yeah, exactly. Well, that's
what Mothership
is. I
thought you were going to tell me about Glenn Danzig.
Oh, yeah, I know. That's why I said off the record.
No, Mothership.
Yeah, it didn't mean off the record. More like just off track.
It's actually going to be on the record.
Yeah,
on the record. How many tracks you guys plan on having on the new CD?
10.
10?
Yeah.
This one has 9.
Plus a
10.
Secret track, woo! Which is going to be Farts. The Farm and Fleet theme song.
I like it.
It's actually going to be a cover of a commercial.
Yeah. You guys should film a commercial for it. It would be awesome.
We're thinking about it, yeah.
Oh, that's... No band has done... I've never seen that done before. That would be awesome. Please actually do that, though.
Yeah, I really want to. Unique. It's up to Charlie.
Come on, Charlie.
Yeah, it's a...
Charlie.
Yeah,
Dave, do you have anything else for us, Dave?
That's it.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Well, anyway.
No, that's fine. Yeah, look out for Mothership coming up soon.
Yeah, we're about halfway there. Halfway there. Yeah.
Halfway done? You guys have all the songs written?
Well, we have more
write
ideas
them as we go.
We have more ideas right now than we actually have time to work on. So the ideas keep coming. We have
a
bunch of ideas that are... waiting to be able to, you know.
So you have 5 done and recorded?
Yeah, I'd say about
not recorded.
Just 5
about
done.
5 done, yeah.
Play them every practice. They're getting solid.
Yeah, so Mothership's going to be the new album. New original artwork coming
the
up,
new,
too.
The new self-titled album, Mothership.
Do you have
album,
the artwork already?
The artwork's actually halfway done. I got to ink it and stuff like that, but we'll have that on the cover and everything like that. And when next time we come by, we'll throw you guys a copy.
Oh,
and
I can't wait.
Yeah.
What did you use to make the album? Did you freehand it, like draw it on paper first and then duplicate it, or did you do it off your computer?
Well, it was all basically just copied at that point, and then
freehand.
Freehand originally, just with ink and
it was freehand.
Colored pencils or crayons.
Crayons,
charcoal.
Oh, you found my
Crayola 64.
Crayola,
pack, right?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it was crayons.
The scratch and sniff ones.
No, I'm thinking of Dead and Gone Again.
Baby calf Sergio.
Sergio, that's not his name.
What was his name again?
Meadows. Yeah, Meadow, Eric. Right. Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Sergio would be a real sweet name for a baby calf, though.
Maybe for a bull.
Her father. No, it was actually all original art, and it was an old piece, but this one's going to be brand new, and Mothership coming out at you. Yeah, absolutely.
Very excited.
We're looking at new material, definitely. But as far as it now, we're glad that we actually got some old stuff.
I'm
going to
release some tapes with that one, right?
Yeah, it's coming out on A-Track.
It's not that old. I mean, come on.
It seems
old to us because, you know, we play it all the time, but
it's coming out on cassette tape, right?
We are glad to give you guys the 8-track of this sucker, and we are going to throw it in.
Yeah, we found a way to make 8-tracks rewind now. So so we're revitalizing the technology.
There you go. That's what we need.
We're at the
forefront.
8-tracks
back. Yeah, that's
I like
what
it. I
bring
like
8-tracksback.com. And that's what we're
digital
doing.
8-tracks.
Not only are we just starting this whole thing, but we want to make sure that the 8-tracks,
Yeah, it's got to catch on.
Exactly, yeah, exactly.
We need your support here. We're doing a Kickstarter, actually, for our 8-track idea.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's a gatefold.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. Well, let's play another Darksiders song, and when we come back, that guy Bill has something to say, apparently.
Oh, my God. This is so good. What do you want to hear?
Oh.
Whatever's on that old album.
Man. BWDL.
Oh, yeah.
Track 8.
Number 8. Let's do it.
Thank you. so concerned. It never dawned on me you run. Come inside, lights are on. Come inside.
The metal experience.
Did you say hookers and blow?
No, I said the metal experience.
That's not nearly as good.
Fuck you. Will you wear the blood? No.
We are back. I am Morgan Danielle with Luco the Stash. That guy Bill and Rabbi Dave, and we've been sitting here with the Darksiders.
And we just heard Beer, Wine, Deli Lotto.
So, Eric, for those that don't know, owns a liquor 7-Eleven type store.
What?
Apparently.
In my dreams.
Yeah. That's what we heard.
And you hang out in front of it like
James
Allen Bob.
I mean, you know, I want to be the guy that comes out with the new convenience store during a zombie apocalypse, basically, you know. I mean, people are going to need things.
What would you call it?
BWDL. I mean, fuck.
He's original.
Beer, Wine, Deli, and Lotto. I mean, who doesn't want to play the Lotto during a zombie apocalypse?
Where would there be money to play the Lotto? Like, the government wouldn't have it.
What about that guy who stuffed the Lotto. $30 worth of pennies?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, S pennies. The guy with the S pennies, yeah.
What?
I mean, he doesn't keep the S pennies.
No, he spends them.
He puts them in his anus and then disperses them around.
Yeah.
His what?
His
the
ass.
The idea is
his
to put them in your ass and then spend them.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
So then he has the confidence over you because he knows that you most likely have, at one time or another, touched his penny that has been in his ass, or
pennies.
You have it in your pocket right now.
That's disgusting.
So now he has the confidence over you.
And clearly, the more pennies you do this with, the more confidence you'll have.
Mm-hmm.
He's like a magic fountain.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if they ever discussed how they came out.
I don't know if they ever discussed how he doesn't get any type of rectum infection, but
well, I mean
that's pennies.
And he cleanses his pennies first.
Yeah, they're antibacterial. It's cool.
That makes sense.
Yeah. I don't know about those pennies. Sounds like he wrecked them to me.
King of the pun.
Well, that guy Bill, are you there?
Yeah.
Hello.
What happened to our beers?
You drink them.
And now for a random moment with that guy Bill.
Don't understand what you said, but I'm gonna sit down.
Only on the Metal Experience.
I am punching your salad.
I am punching your salad.
I am.
That's my favorite part.
I
don't know what you said, but I'm going to sit down.
Good.
Sorry.
All right. So my random moment is Nerf Wars. They're awesome. So awesome that at Google, every office has their own Nerf arsenal.
Really?
What?
Yeah.
Nerf I hope guns. They're wearing safety glasses.
Every office has a Nerf arsenal.
In Google, every office, they have their own separate
How
Nerf
do we
arsenal.
Start broadcasting out of Google?
Yeah. How can we do that? Look into that, guys.
Look into that.
Google's
we'll
machine.
Get right on it.
Good.
Why don't
do
you
that.
Hit up
That's
Google
awesome.
And tell them
you
we want...
You guys posted Nerf War pictures today. You had a Nerf War, didn't you?
Yesterday, yeah.
Yeah, I saw those pictures.
It was awesome.
I was extremely jealous.
Those megas didn't hurt, man.
The what?
There's a
Nerf mega
oh,
gun.
Boo-hoo.
The darts,
can't take a little Nerf
The darts
hit.
Are huge, and they hurt
That was
like
the size
bitch.
Of a quarter.
Awesome.
Yeah, well, but they the have, normal like, darts are
Have you ever
tiny.
Been paintballing, or are you guys just pussies?
I've been paintballing.
Okay, well then that doesn't hurt compared to
I painted my balls.
I don't know why.
You know what?
I'm
going to bring over a mega one day and I'm going to shoot you in the
it's
face.
The
but then
level.
You can tell me if it hurts or not.
Yeah, you know what? I think Nerf has like mini guns now, right? Don't they have like mini guns?
They've got all kinds. They even
have a
plastic
Gatling
darts.
Gun.
They have a Gatling gun, yeah.
Yeah, they have Nerf, actually have an Nerf atomic has, bomb.
Yeah.
Nerf
atomic
atom.
Bomb.
Isn't it just like huge?
Yeah.
You shoot and it's like
Well, yeah, it's like 700
yeah, it's
bucks.
Like a,
it's my
like a foam
God.
Mushroom cloud.
And it comes out with all these like darts and
pellets. It looks seriously
and stuff.
Like
they
laser
a,
tag.
I want to go to there.
All right. Well, thank you for that random fact, Bill. Anything else?
No. All good. That was the random moment
gotcha.
For the day.
No.
All, random all moment.
Good. Nerf.
Google
Get
has
it.
Nerf
Got it.
arsenals.
To save the universe.
I have that song on my phone.
Oh!
Oh my God.
Save every one of us.
Yeah.
Captain of the universe.
Someone's got some range.
Woo.
No shit. I have two Queen songs on my phone. That's one of them. The other one's the Highlander theme song. That's nice. It.
Yeah. Was anybody really truly afraid of Flash Gordon though? Look, think about it. He's like, Flash. You know, he's like, his tights.
Who wasn't inspired by Ming the
You
Merciless.
Remind
yeah,
me of
right?
Jim Gaffigan in skinny form.
Yeah, I don't know.
In skinny Gaffigan. Form?
Does
in
he not remind form? You of Jim Gaffigan? I mean, his sense of humor?
And yeah, his real
Jim
name
Gaffigan.
Is Ruben.
Point
Ruben?
Four.
Ruben Raffigan.
He was named after a sandwich his mom liked.
Oh, yeah, that's exactly it. The heist has been uncovered. No, no, Flash Gordon, good movie, but yeah, not really too afraid of him. Like, I could...
Well, he played for
you.
The Jets.
Yeah,
the quarterback.
Yeah.
Did anyone Flesh Gordon?
Fleshlight Gordon?
wait.
Leave it to Eric to bring up Flesh Gordon.
Well, did anyone else realize that in Flash Gordon, Ming the Merciless has the device to make the earthquake shake? You know, earthquake happened, but he doesn't know what the earth is.
He did not pass third grade. Ming the Merciless.
He's like, oh, but what planet is that? Oh, it's Earth. Oh, and then he has a button for an earthquake that just doesn't
have
make
ever,
any sense.
Have you ever watched those old shows? They're awesome, though.
The yeah, of course. The
my
yeah.
dad, my
great,
dad bought the whole entire seat. The you whites. Know the collection. I was like, yes,
the
my talkies. Dirty undies.
I know I'm,
the talkies.
White.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, anyway,
they were silver.
Flash Gordon. Yeah. Flash Gordon's doing lines of coke in that movie Ted.
Yeah, he is.
Which is pretty sweet. He's like, holy shit, Flash Gordon.
Yeah. Wow.
Well, anyway.
Anyways,
that's all I got.
Unsigned band pick of the week.
Oh yeah, that's
yeah. How did we start talking about Flash Gordon?
Started singing it.
I think it was Paul.
Paul,
you
just
started
singing
it?
It?
Yeah, he
it's
started
always
thinking.
Paul.
It's always
Song
Paul.
Comes to mind, I must share.
Blame the brass section.
Well, let's do it.
Now it's time for...
Hey, man, look what I found!
Only on the Metal Experience.
Huh?
Dave's what? Got the name of the song.
Well, anyway, it's Your Hero is a Villain, right?
Yes.
Yeah. What's
With
the issue?
Their song? Dave, what's
anyway,
the name of the song?
The name White. Of the band is Your Hero is a Villain from Kerman, California. And what are we doing? Are we doing Oon or Toof?
I was doing Toof for Morgan, or what are we doing?
Well, the song that you have, and then one of the songs Zuko has. So what's the song that you have, Dave?
I have the song, what the hell was it? White Noise.
White Noise?
Well, we'll do White Noise and... playing.
I'm Well, I expect that type of language at Denny's, but not here.
Well, that's too freaking bad. You hear me?
Because we're throwing it back to Morgan and Luco on The Metal Experience.
Woo, woo, woo! And we just heard Your Hero is a Villain from Kerman, California. I think I'm pronouncing that right. Kerman, with the songs White Noise and Equivalent Exchange.
Yeah, little blurb about them. They're actually raising money right now. They've got 8 days left on their Indiegogo campaign. They're doing a bunch of raising money for their new EP, Dark Passenger. So they have to raise $750. Actually, I donated $10 to them last night. So they're like $351 right now. But it definitely helps. I mean, any recording time, it's like $100 per song for them. They're trying to record 5 songs. It's the first album that they've made in 3 years. But they're actually playing Battle for Knot Fest, which is that huge Slipknot festival in California. They're going to be playing Fullerton, California on October 6th. So definitely keep your eyes open for them. They're amazing. And I'm so excited for the new CD because actually we get a copy of it once it gets done. So
yay!
Pretty stoked about that. But
it sounded awesome.
Yeah, they're awesome. And they have a female in the band too.
Yeah? What does she do?
She does background vocals. And I want to say she plays guitar. Look that up, Dave.
I think harmonica as
what
well.
Did you hear a little harmonica?
Yeah, in the band?
Little harp.
Blues says
harp.
Background vocals. It's okay. He'll look it up. But Your Hero is a Villain. That was pretty cool.
Yeah, totally goes with it. Distorted blues harp.
Perfect,
yeah.
Luca.
Lorenzo Lamas. I'm sorry. We were talking about Lorenzo Lamas, and I was just... Yeah. My mind's just still stuck on all
Renegade.
The Laminators out there.
Renegade. We know there's Laminators out
there.
Yeah,
too bad Charlie's not here with us right now. Because
Charlie,
he's a
Laminator.
He's a huge Laminator.
You're a huge Laminator. That's
he'll
really
call back
funny.
Right now, actually, if you're still...
Yeah, you guys talking shit about Lorenzo Lamas?
Yeah, it's not often we talk about it. It's not...
He's actually like trying to point into that direction for the conversation.
So, Connie does bass and vocals.
There you go, bass and vocals.
I wonder if they like Lorenzo Lamas.
And an electric harmonica.
There you go.
You were saying,
you weren't joking. That's a thing.
No, I'm kidding. I don't.
Oh.
They have electric violin. Why not?
I thought you were.
That's
electric violin
thing.
Actually makes sense. Electric harmonica does not.
Leave yellow card alone.
The old electric harmonica.
Like hey, do you guys have Darksider masks?
Oh, man. Masks! that's actually a touchy subject.
Yes, it is. Wait, quick question.
I wanted to do masks.
How's that touchy?
For your next album, is it going to be called Darksiders 2, Darksidier?
No.
Mothership.
They already told you it was going to be called the
Darksidier. I like that.
Darksidiest.
Or dark,
self-titled Darksidier.
Or Darksiders 2.
For our second self-titled album.
Darksiders 2, Electric Boogaloo.
Welcome to the Darksiders.
And the titular track will be Shadow of the System 2.
Yeah, they're all just sequels.
They're just
songs.
Sequels to the same songs, you know. We're really original. We really want to try to break through
every
here.
Every single song has a sequel song on
yeah,
the
we're
new
inspired
CD.
By yeah, exactly. Hollywood. Really
BWDL 2, Dead and Gone 2.
Yeah, and then the third album will be a reboot of the first album.
Yeah, exactly. And it's going to be black and white opposites, you know, yeah, like negative, yeah.
All the same songs, but with
different
band members, basically. All
you
the same
have
songs.
A great
and your
concept.
Next, and your next shirts will be white and with black.
I like
so
it.
Everything,
I like
the
it.
Whole theme thing going on here.
You guys have the next couple of years just set then.
Oh, yeah, exactly. Color schemes, however many colors you can come
you
up
go.
With, man. We got it made.
I love it. I can't wait.
It's all about reboots.
How high can you count? You know, that's really how it is. I can count to 99.
Well, we have a few more songs off this album.
Epic.
We haven't played all of it. What do we have next? Anybody? Anybody? Name out a track. What's your favorite track? Paul?
GA, yeah. Throw it on some GA.
GA.
That's going on.
What does that mean?
That's the last one.
Going on a minute.
Track 9.
Yeah, we're fond of acronyms.
Okay.
Yeah,
let's do it.
Grand Theft Auto?
Everything's a fucking acronym, an F-A.
Let's do that one and Zero Hour, huh? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Ah.
All right, yes. Not two, but one.
That's a punk metal song, or as we call it,
ooh,
pedal.
Punk metal.
Or
punk metal?
Monk.
Pedal?
Yeah, actually, monk. Yeah, our genre is monk.
Monk. I like it.
Nice.
Perfect.
I was burping.
These are all the original songs, not the second, the sequels or anything.
Okay, cool.
We'll be right back.
This is the Metal Experience, and now back to Morgan and Luco.
And we are back, and we just heard another twofer. We heard Gun Automatic
with a G
and 0 Hour off of the Darksiders self-titled Shatter the System CD. Well, I am Luco Blaze with Morgan Danielle. The Darksiders, we got Rabbi Dave and that guy Bill also sitting over there hanging out. Nice, is it sweaty over there? It's kind of sweaty in here, too.
Heat's on.
It's not that bad over here.
The good thing is I printed my stuff out today, so I don't have to sit in Dave's sweaty chair with his ass sweat.
But I thought that was the best part of the night.
Well, Bill, you're wrong. Anyways, back to the Darksiders. What were those two songs that we heard about?
Gone. I don't know. Do you know?
Gone Automatic.
Well, Going Automatic was the last song on the album. That was actually one of the earlier ones we came up with too. Both of those were like really early songs that we came up with. But they were fun filled, to the point, brash. That's what you say, brass. But
yeah, what the hell is Going Automatic like about anyway?
Going Automatic is just about full frontal war. You know what I mean? Actually, I drew a
full frontal,
like church war.
I had a drawing one
basically
time,
like religion.
Yeah, yeah. Like frenzy. One of the drawings I did one time of Going Automatic was like a priest just opening fire on all of his people.
The congregation. Yeah,
the congregation.
I think it's an astonishing recollection of the kinds of things that TV evangelists have been doing, and basically they're killing your mind.
Nice.
Yeah, so we just took it up to the next level and literally killed those.
Wow, you have serious dark songs on your album.
Yeah, but it's all in good fun.
You know,
I mean,
killing priests and stuff, you know.
Hey, guess what? You know what? They're not the best people.
So what about 0 Hour? What's 0 Hour about?
Oh, Zero Hour. Well, you know, that's like a stalker.
What you've been after.
Yeah, Night Stalker, basically.
Richard Ramirez?
Kind of, in a way. I don't know, but I mean, it's like, you know, that kind of epic tale of somebody like hiding in the shadows, you know. It's really a...
Your time has come.
Like Ted Bundy hiding in the shadows and jerking off?
Yeah.
He does that. That's, he did that.
That was exactly what
Yeah, but
not
about. The whole jerking off thing. But
just hanging out,
it's
though?
Just implied.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I suppose.
He may
yeah.
be touching something in his pants.
Yeah, those were all like real fast songs to the point. And yeah, they were good. They were good. For their time, they're still good.
To the point.
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Dark. Dark.
Do the Darksiders have any music videos?
No. No, unfortunately.
No.
No, no, we have some ideas, but
we have a zero ranking on YouTube right now.
We have some live videos, but we haven't really done too much with them yet. We have ideas in the making of a couple songs, Mothership. We have a whole like the whole concept built out as far as what we want to do with them.
Yeah, there's always ideas, yeah. But I mean money is
just hard to implement sometimes.
Once we rob a bank, we'll get ready.
We were smoking this one place out down here actually. We don't come right, you know, out this way.
We've got a couple banks in mind right now that we're looking for. We're not going to tell you which ones, but, you know, hey. If we could go ATMs, well, that's the route.
Oh, jeez.
We are not going to be doing that.
Yeah, we got
though.
A song that we're writing that's going to be about robbing an armored car.
Yeah.
And we're actually going to film ourselves robbing an armored car for the video.
Like
there you go. There
yeah.
you go.
Yeah.
So I'm
like going to
watch an episode
show.
Of Cops and see yeah. the dark side.
You know? There you go. That's yeah, going to be the music video.
It's like a retro video. Yeah.
Oh,
exactly.
My God.
Yeah. We want to throw it retro.
Yeah, but the logistics of it's, you know, just out the window.
We want to be on Fox.
Still working out the details.
Yeah, yeah.
We're
I've been stalking a route. So
we actually are thinking, we're actually starting to come up with this idea for a new sitcom, too, involving the band.
Please do tell.
Well, it's like it's a sitcom. Obviously, it's a funny show. We're all
called the Darksiders.
Yeah, exactly. We don't know yet, but we all have families, and we all bring them to the same house, and then all the people in the house they start like you know throwing things at each other.
Yeah, and it's basically a reality sitcom of their reactions during band practice.
True. Yeah, we haven't gotten any further than that.
Yeah, and our band practice actually broadcasts throughout the house, speaker in every room.
It's I'm still
yeah.
Yeah, we did a really good Nielsen like the first time around, but then
the
second time we showed it did not do good. So we're trying to figure out what went wrong the first time. And
we have
thinking
a full focus group marketing team.
Yeah, I'm thinking the first time was bad because we didn't play our own songs. But now I think the second time we're going to try to do our own songs.
That was where the covers of the jingles came in.
Okay.
Mm-hmm,
Yeah.
I've been listening to them play covers of jingles for the last 4 hours.
Yeah, see, like, the Sure song doesn't fit it. Like, you know, raise your hand if you're sure.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, that, you know, Kit Kat song. It just doesn't do it over a sitcom sort of thing.
Gotcha.
Yeah,
gotcha.
Into it.
Well, that was an interesting
we're looking
idea.
For a parlay, really.
A parlay.
I like it. Where can people
Are we
find
betting right now? I don't know what's going
where
on.
Where can people find the Darksiders online and your merch and all that jazz?
PBR? Explain it to the crowd. Public relations brass.
We have our stuff obviously on Reverb Nation. It's free.
This whole CD, all the tracks are on reverbnation.com/the Darksiders. They're all the same tracks. You can download them for free.
Yeah.
So if you like them, download them. They're yours.
Yeah, you know, because the man did not want to charge $1 for our
songs.
Yeah,
fuck that. I mean, shit.
The dollar store.
If you like it,
yeah, no,
we want you to
even,
have it.
Yeah, we are not That's worthy of the dollar store. We're just we're the nickel store.
Anything
I
else?
We're actually on like we have that CD.
Well, the Facebook
and
the Facebook
all kinds
links
of stuff,
to
like
the Reverb.
Different things, but it's honestly sometimes it gets
CD Baby.
Even,
oh yeah, iTunes. Yeah. If you actually want to spend money on the stuff, you can buy it on iTunes.
Woo.
Or come see us at a show. You can buy
the best
actual
place
CD.
To catch our stuff, get our CDs, the real thing, T-shirts. And just a kick-ass experience is to come have a lot of fun with us because we
exactly.
have more fun when you're there.
Exactly. Mothership's going to be the new album coming out. And September 20th, we're kicking it with Genotype. And
they're playing all
Spark
the new
Plug
songs
Assassins.
From Mothership.
And where is that at, so, September 20th?
The Old Town Inn.
You know what time that bad boy starts?
I'm thinking, what time are we on?
I think it's 8 p.m. I'm not sure.
I figure 8 p.m.
Show, you
come in earlier if you want to check out all the bands
because it's all good bands at night.
And everybody's super cool that's there. That's one of the best things is it's always fun, great time when you play with other people that everybody's just
You're looking for good metal, come on out.
Yeah, yeah. About supporting the scene, you know, you got to watch the bands that you play with too, you know.
Well, these guys right here support the scene. Yeah, fuck yeah. Anybody,
hell yeah.
So,
yeah, metal.
And we haven't even seen you guys yet.
We've been so busy.
You don't care about us, do you?
September 20th. We're going to try and make it out. Nice. Definitely. Yes. We try and make it out to every single band that's ever been on the show.
Yes.
Nice.
We will definitely.
And sometimes there's actually been a lot of bands where, not a lot, but there's been a couple where we're planning on going to see them and then we show up and they drop the show.
Yeah. Seneca Falls. We're talking about you.
That happened like 8 times with them. It was weird.
Wow.
Like it kind of got.
Do you think they were harboring resentment?
I don't know. But every time we're like, oh, we're going to go see him, they would drop the show or, oh, now the band's broken up.
I think it's just
up,
because
or, it
I made fun of that dude's
weird.
Umbrella tattoo too much.
Well, that was weird. I don't know
umbrella,
why you
like
do.
Umbrella Corporation?
Right here.
Yeah.
No, it was
like
an umbrella.
On his cheek. And I kept seeing that he was.
A little baby umbrella right here.
I kept singing that Rihanna song to him.
That catches tears.
Well, ironically, one of the next
diverse
songs.
Tears.
One of the newer songs on the new album is about you guys not coming to see us.
Oh, no.
I'm kidding.
Go back to
yeah,
everything.
That's Stagger
too.
Oh my god! Hey, it's Dead and Gone too.
Fuck.
Damn it!
No, I'm kidding. I'm kidding.
Now, do you guys have any other shows set up besides that one, or is just that the only one coming up so far?
At this point, it's the only one coming up. We kind of want to start focusing more on getting the next CD all written and recorded and everything.
Hell yeah.
Mothership.
But, like, we always try and play at this cool place in West Chicago called the Cairo Bar.
It's the Cairo coming up.
Yeah,
Genotype
Andrew.
Sex Show.
That place
cool
rules.
Place,
yeah,
everybody there is awesome.
Yeah, Cairo, West Chicago.
Yeah, we always love playing there.
Wait, not Chicago, but West Chicago?
West Chicago,
yeah.
Like
that's 59 and
right off of 59.
Yeah,
yeah.
North Avenue.
That's not in Chicago at all.
No, it's
not really.
West of Chicago.
It's like down North Avenue.
Fake Chicago.
West Chicago sign.
Yeah.
It's west of Chicago.
It's not here.
Yeah, west of Chicago.
My aunt lives in West Chicago, so when people say West Chicago, I'm like, I know where that is.
Not so Chicago, but yeah.
No, no, yeah, there's no Chicago involved.
Not a drop of Chicago in your system.
Oh my goodness.
Well, all right, well, let's do this. It's Luku Roundup time.
Hey, this is the Q-Shirt, and I'm going to slam these two beers while Morgan gives you the local roundup brought to you by the Chicago Metal Alliance. So sit down, shut up, and make sure you check out the metalexperience.com. We love you, Morgan.
Hey, what's up? I'm Rob Salem, host of The Forge, the home of the best underground rock and metal the Midwest and beyond has to offer. The Forge airs weekdays at 1 p.m. Eastern, noon Central, and streams free from RadioFreeKokomo.org. Make sure that your speakers are cranked to 11 when you tune in, because you're going to hear all the killer neck-wrecking, ear-shattering, face-melting, local and regional rock and metal that I can find. And you're only going to hear it on The Forge at RadioFreeKokomo.org.
The Local Roundup with Morgan on the Metal Experience.
Can you hear me? Oh, yeah, that's me. Okay, anyways, here we go. Heatstorm Annihilation, still looking for a bass player. I don't know
how
that's possible.
How are they still looking for a bass player?
I have no idea. Disrupting the Abacus, looking for a keyboard player and background vocalist. Bleed for the Fallen is starting auditions very soon now for a new vocalist, so definitely hit them up. Lords of the Drunken Pirate Crew, looking for a new guitar player. Return to Flesh needs a bass player. Remora, looking for a drummer, and All the Way Alive needs a bass player and a drummer. You guys aren't missing any members, right?
No.
Good. All right. Well, we're still waiting on bands to send us their MP3 tracks of Sweepers that we can put in our show. Introduce yourselves, your band, play some music behind it, and introduce the Metal Experience, and we'll play it as a sweeper. Just a little like blurb in between our little commercial bits, so... MetalExperience@yahoo.com. You can submit it. Doesn't have to be long at all. It could be obnoxious. It could be funny. It could be
dumb. It could
dumb.
Be boring.
It could be boring.
I could hate serious. It.
Yeah.
We'll
so
still play it.
Seriously, bands, do this. We want to hear it.
Don't
we
want to
play new stuff.
Yeah, don't
it's
make
great
it boring,
promotion.
Though.
Get creative.
Get creative. Cross Me, the hardcore band from Milwaukee, is having their benefit show on September 13th for their singer Tyler, who was in a motorcycle accident.
Brutal.
It's in Indianapolis, and it's going to be a great time with a bunch of bands to raise money. So they also have Cross Me t-shirts that are still for sale for $6, and you can donate directly to the band via PayPal at crossmehardcore@gmail.com. So nothing is too small. Anything helps. Definitely help Tyler with his medical bills on that. Deaf 2, the heavy degent band from Rathdrum, Idaho.
The what?
Heavy
degent.
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 Just
the,
gent.
The J. The D is silent, you goofball.
That's the joke.
Degent.
Degent. Anyway, they just released their first two tracks.
Wait, what was the name of the band I was listening to you saying degent?
Deaf 2.
How do you spell that?
D-E-A-F space T-O.
Oh, thank you,
son. Deaf 2. Okay, anyway, their first two tracks called Persuasive, Evasive, and False Innocence, featuring Ben Hogsland of the Extortionist. Sorry. They are off their album that's been coming out right now, so definitely check that out. You can get it for free off the band's Bandcamp and their Facebook as well. Insatient, the black and death metal band from Los Angeles, just released their new EP, Remnants. It's available now on their Facebook page. I'll Be an Empire, the progressive metalcore band from Kenesha, Georgia, released their EP, Thelema.
Where?
Kenesha. K-E-N-E-S-A-W.
That's where you're from, right?
Kenesha?
Kenesha?
Yeah.
We're having a reunion next week.
Kenesha? I don't know.
Next week, Kenesha.
They're from Georgia.
Kenesha!
Thelema is out on iTunes now. You can hear the album on their Bandcamp as well. It's just $5 if you would like to download it. Through These Words, the metal southern rock band from St. Catharines, Thorold, Canada.
Thorold?
Thorold.
How you spell that?
T-H-O-R-O-L-D.
Town check.
Thorold. I don't know. It's Canadian. They just released their song called Choices. You can hear it on Facebook. Also, the band has a music video out right now for Reliant. It's on
Reliant?
YouTube. Whatever. I'm not good at English.
Reliant?
It's been a while.
When's the last time you've heard that word?
It's been 2 weeks,
English?
Okay?
That's impossible.
Anyway,
you can rely on her.
It's on YouTube and the album.
Listen,
Revision.
Guys, you can Reliant on me.
Revision is...
Reliant. I'm sorry. You can Reliant on me.
Released in 2 weeks.
Reliant?
I guess, maybe.
Say the whole thing again. I was talking.
No. Anyways.
Say that word again.
I don't want to.
Do it.
No.
Come on.
Reliant.
I tried. What is it? Reliant?
Reliant.
Reliant?
I was really reliant on the fact that this place had burger I wanted.
Anyways, Raven Among Doves, the metal groove deathcore band from Manchester, New Jersey, just released their single Bastard Child. It's on their band's Bandcamp page right now.
Bandcamp?
Bandcamp. Victims of Contagion, the technical death metal band with a hint of progressive grind.
Oh, a hint.
From Pittsburgh. It just released their song, The Parasitic Unborn. That's off their upcoming EP that will be released September 27th. It's on the band's SoundCloud page. A Feast for Kings, the progressive metal band.
They had a dash of
a hint.
A hint.
Yeah.
Okay.
A Feast for Kings, progressive metal band from Kentucky, lost their vocalist back in May. They've raised over $2,600 with memorial shirts and will be shipping them out in September. The band thanks all their fans and supporters for their donations, for their time of grieving. Check out their EP, Hell on Earth, on iTunes now, and check out the band's Big Cartel page for more merch. Varsity, the post-hardcore band from Orlando, Florida, just released their song Who We Are Part 1 on their YouTube page. It's a behind the scenes of them recording a bunch of upcoming sneak previews off their EP, so definitely look that up on YouTube. Devastating Truth, the deathcore band from Rotterdam area of the Netherlands, now have shirts, and they're available for purchase on their Big Cartel page. I tried buying one last night, and they don't ship to the United States.
Wait,
so
where are they from?
They're from Netherlands, so...
Where's that at?
Netherlands. They're islands.
Oh, no.
So you might want to change that because I want a shirt.
You might want to change that.
I want them. I'm in the United
States.
They're
probably like, fuck you, Americans.
Fallen Captive.
Flip it over, maybe.
Fallen Captive, the hardcore band from Cleveland, Ohio, just released their second track off their album, The Damage a Man Can Do. It's called Damages. Mm-hmm. You can check it out on Facebook and head to the band's Big Cartel page to purchase their merch. Hold on, I've got one of my page here. All these pages. Oh, yeah. Check out Corey Rocks Your World. She's on Sunday nights at Sonic Asylum Radio from 8 to 11. Metal Deli with Kimmy is on Mondays. She's got new shows every week, and then just gets rebroadcasted on a bunch of different stations throughout the week. She's
and
awesome.
And speaking of, we were just in Seattle last week, and we posted our stickers with their stickers all around Seattle.
On a nice.
Bridge on the beach, looking
under
over
bridges.
The ocean.
We went to a bunch
in
of
Elk
record
High.
Stores. We left our stickers and everything. Their stickers there
awesome.
Too.
Awesome.
It was pretty sweet.
Todd Bridges.
We went to Todd Bridges' his
you
house.
Went to Todd Bridges' house.
He nice. Showed me his no, thing, and it was weird.
Whoa! Did you put the sticker on?
Todd or Jeff?
I wrapped the sticker around it.
Anyways,
Jeff Bridges was, he wasn't there, but.
What about Bo Bridges?
He called in. Bo Bridges was.
He's lives, always around.
Lives across the way.
Is he?
Check out.
So, I noticed you brought a koozie.
Alliance.
Yeah,
you
bring that from home?
I'm yeah. not done with it.
Yeah, I would have brought one for everyone, but.
No, it's all cool.
They only had like, one.
I better bring my koozie.
I love koozies.
All right, well, we're getting Darksiders Kurt. Lions koozie. Printing, check them out. They are official printer of our stickers.
Bob the
flyers.
Printer.
Bob the Printer is amazing. Metal Experience, Corey rocks your world. Metal Deli, he's awesome. Great
he
prices.
He prints for all of
prints
us.
Prints for
is what
all
you,
of us.
Trying to say.
He can make decals for cars.
Oh, my
he can
God.
Make flyers, stickers, Whoa. Anything you're looking yes. for. So Alliance Printing, Bob the Printer is awesome. Check him out. Next week, we have Birdie Garcia on our show.
Birdie.
She is a journalist. She's going to be doing more of an interview toward us with just discussions.
Really?
Should be awesome.
Should be weird.
And we should have, I'm going to make it a surprise for right now because we're getting confirmations. But yeah. we are having two bands call in. We're doing our first, like, little interviews over the phone, which should be weird.
We better prepare stuff because I don't know how I talk about poop and farts and stuff
well,
over the phone.
We can't
just
really
phone it in, dude.
Just phone it in. Phone in fart noises.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess so.
We have a lot of more room in here.
Yeah.
But that should be interesting. Birdie Garcia is going to be on our show. She actually did an interview with us not too long ago. She's doing a couple of articles for her blogs that she was looking for some insight
Bliggity
about.
Blogs.
The music industry and the Chicago scene. So that was pretty fun. So now we get to have her on here and interview her. So, and she'll interview us.
We
so
should interview the shit
changes.
Out of her in the face.
Okay. Well, thank you guys for coming
thank
on.
You.
We
Hell
really
yeah,
appreciate
thank you.
Having
Excellent.
You guys
thank
back.
You.
Thank you for the shirts and the awesome CD.
Thank you guys
yeah.
over there too. Hell yeah.
And so, once
for
again,
having
be,
us.
Before we got one more song to listen to. But once again, where can everyone find The Darksiders, everything that is The Darksiders, and the show's coming up.
ReverbNation.com and Facebook. Look up The Darksiders. We'll be there.
And Mothership should be out soon.
Yeah.
It's unfortunate it's not called Darksiders.
Or Darksiders 2, or yeah.
The Darksider side of The Darksiders.
But we're looking at, definitely coming out with
yeah,
the
Yeah, we might have to change our band name to The Darksiders.
What's
I mean,
wrong
that
with
does
this guy's
good.
Face? Is this a Cyclops alien?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Cyclops alien, huh?
Yeah, it is. He's the cutest of them all. We were going to have plush dolls made for tonight.
Yeah, plush
you know
masks.
The plush dolls didn't
I
make
want
it yet.
Plush dolls?
We had all four.
Plush Darksider
yeah.
What
heads.
About bobbleheads? You know how they're making those big bobbleheads
oh,
with the
yeah.
different
Fuck
characters?
Fuck bobbleheads, all right?
We're going to have Darksider cereal with the skull.
Yeah, yeah,
yes,
skull.
Marshmallows.
It's actually
Darksider cereal with the marshmallows that look
yeah,
like
yeah.
Count Chocula.
Can you imagine any other way you can whore out your band that
Action
we're at
Action figures.
Just, Christ, Kiss
just,
hasn't
just
done
follow
cereal
everything
yet.
Kiss has done.
Yeah, Kiss
Dark
hasn't Darksider's
the flamethrower.
Darksider's the toilet paper. What else does he have?
Oh, man, I hadn't thought of that.
From Spaceballs?
That's a badass idea.
From Spaceballs?
Badass.
Mm.
That's you're the puck guy, man. What the hell?
And of course, everything is saved on our website, themetalexperience.com. All
dot
of
com.
Our unsigned band picks.
I wish we would have got it.
All of
the
our old shows.
Com.
I don't want that as our website. No.
Yeah.
No.
Missed opportunities. Anyway, you guys have a show coming up at Yodi on the 20th of this month.
Yes.
That's a what day? A Saturday,
Saturday night.
Saturday,
make it out.
It's one of Sparkplug Assassins. They have probably a handful of shows coming up, and then one of the guys is moving, unfortunately.
Oh, no.
So catch them before they're gone. And then also Surrender to the Throne, it's their first show.
Ooh.
So one of
Virgins.
One, yeah. So they're, you know, like I said, they're all super cool. So
mm-hmm.
it's going to be a good time.
Mm-hmm.
And, of course, Genotype.
Genotype rocks it always.
Woo!
So Charlie's going to be pulling double duty?
Double
yeah, yeah.
duty.
Yeah, not the first time he's done that.
Does
so.
He do? Do you guys do a break in between and have a band play, or he just stays up
no,
there?
No, he stays up there the whole time.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
awesome.
We make him.
It's easier that
he's
way.
Stay there, Charlie!
He's chained up there.
Nice.
Mount Prospect.
Shackle around his ankle. You stay, Charlie. No, boy. Like stay there.
Yeah, he'll just wander off if you don't whip him.
We need a trident.
You know, they make those little shocker things that if
the neck shocker collar thing.
Oh, but that's just cruel. I mean, if there's anything
like stabbing
we're
another
against,
human
it's
being
cruelty.
With a trident is cool.
We only turn ours up to 5%.
Yeah, I can't bring up still. Cattle prod stories though because Meadow, you know.
Because about yeah.
No, they make those like
respect,
little electricity shocker things.
Yeah, that's called a cattle prod.
No, it doesn't. No.
Yeah, we're coming up with Darksiders branding skulls.
Darksiders the cattle prod?
Yep.
Yes, exactly.
When is there Darksiders costume for Halloween?
Oh, soon, hopefully.
Well, we got to get our own masks first, so, you know, and then we can...
Yeah, we're looking at cashing in at 2023.
Look into duplicating.
2023. That's our big year.
Yeah, that's
9 years from now.
Now, that's hoping that you guys
nine?
Are still on the...
Nice.
Yeah,
oh,
yeah, exactly.
Wait, no,
we're
longer
we're
than
thinking
that.
Ahead
Sorry.
Here. We're thinking ahead. And we're hoping that meteor doesn't hit beforehand.
There's a meteor.
That's 2025, dude. We're good.
Yeah, I think we're, yeah.
In 2025, there's supposed to be a meteor that hits?
Yeah. Supposedly, yeah.
Yeah.
Shit, we got some time. Let's party.
That's what I'm saying. Yeah, exactly. Hard rock, heavy metal.
All right.
Darksiders' fourth album will be the meteor.
Oh, my God.
Then we're going to think of Dead and Gone 3. No, I hope we do it faster.
The fourth self-titled album.
Yes.
Called The Darkside Years.
Yes.
Session 5.
The meteor, meteor.
The meteor, the meteor.
Yeah, yes.
What's the What's the last song we're gonna hear tonight?
It's called "Clever Ways." It was actually the first song we ever wrote.
Oh. Well, thank you guys again for coming out, and we will hopefully see you guys
thank
on the
you.
20th at
yeah.
Yodi.
Oh, yeah, yeah, absolutely. Woo! Yeah, absolutely.
And we are the Metal Experience. We've been here all beautiful night. It's great outside. It's a little sweaty in here, but. With the Darksiders and those two big sweaty men across from us, Rabbi Dave and that guy Bill, have been.
I'm big. Out. He's the sweaty one.
Which, by the way, we all did the ALS challenge. We all have videos of us doing it. Thanks, guys, for doing that. That was awesome. They did it almost
immediately.
It was awesome.
I had a busy weekend.
Speed Freak,
so I had
though.
To do it right
Speed
away.
Freak, on the other hand,
yeah,
those sons
of
bitches. I haven't seen
cunts.
Them post that yet, so we need to get on that. We should show up at their band space
and
with
just
a bucket
dump
of
water. And then maybe I'll drop a couple fart bombs and we'll peace.
We'll be like, see ya, bitches.
Why don't we just throw dried ice in the water?
No. That
people
would
just throw it
them.
On them.
I'm not trying to kill them.
I am.
Kill
Let's
them.
Do
It'll
it.
Just burn a bit.
Let's
that
do it.
That I don't want to do to them.
Well, the Darksiders with the song Clever
Poppy!
Waste. Let's do it. Hut! We'll be right back.
feet.